Cowboy boots could be called the soul of the Western experience. They died with their boots on at Little Bighorn. Bad men were buried still wearing them on Boot Hill. In the modern-day West, cowboy boots still ride tall in the saddle, but McLeod and the Midnight Cowboy aside, they never did wear as well in other parts of the country. That is, until The Urban Cowboy. That movie helped kick the national sales of Western wear, including boots, to an all-time high. But then along came the slowdown. This is the story of the goods, the boots, and the not-so-ugly truth.
Since the Urban Cowboy days, it hasn't really peaked up again.
At Allen's Boot Center in Austin, James Curtis says sales aren't what they were during the boom Urban Cowboy years, but they're doing all right.
Well, they never used to be comfortable, but now I used to wear tennis shoes, and now they're more comfortable. The exotic leather makes them softer, easier to wear, and they're more comfortable.
One real comfortable boot that's revitalizing the industry is the roper boot, a style popularized by country western singer George Strait.
As far as standing on your feet and walking around quite a bit, it probably is going to be the most comfortable. It's also got a low top on it, which is fantastic, mainly because it keeps a lot of the heat off your calf.
The idea among bootmakers now is to tell the American consumer that you don't have to be a cowboy to wear Western boots.
Urban cowboy craze or no, as long as the spirit of the American West lives on, so will the boots that won the West. Todd Chipola, News 36.